Hello friends. Today, we are going to have a short introduction with the books of the New Testament. After the resurrection of Jesus Christ, he commissioned his disciples to go and spread the message of the kingdom of God, all across the world. Now, the early Christian community had a strong eschatological hope and they anticipated the end of the world and the immediate establishment of the God's reign. Hence, this delayed their writing of records. But later by the mid of the first century, written records of Jesus Christ gained prominence. Let us travel across the journey of the books of the New Testament. The 27 books of the New Testament, essential for the faith and salvation of mankind, was written over a span of 40 years. We can classify these books basically into three different types of literature, namely, historical writings, letters, and apocalyptic literature. We often feel Gospel to be the first written work in the New Testament. However, much before the Gospel it were the letters that became a part of the first Christian literature. These letters were designed to answer the immediate problems faced by the early church, and to strengthen the faith of the community living in distant places. The conversion of Paul, from a zealous Jew to a traveling missionary, led to the spreading of the love of Jesus in many parts of the world. He planted churches and through his letters encouraged them to be rooted in their faith. In the early half of the first century, Paul produced the earliest Christian documents. The Epistle to the Churches Thessalonica is believed to be the first written book in the New Testament. Following it, Paul wrote letters to the churches in Galatia and Philippi. A personal letter to Philemon, speaking about reconciliation and brotherhood, and two letters to the churches he planted in the province of Corinth, and latter to the church in Rome, which is believed not to be started by Paul. By the mid-60s, death had come to the first generation believers of the early church, the one who had either known Jesus or had seen his resurrection. This led to the production of written records of a more permanent nature. Letter remained an important means of Christian communication even if they were written now not by Paul himself but in his name to preserve his spirit and authority. Composed in the period between 70 to 100 CE were the second letter to the Thessalonians, Colossians, Ephesians, and the very personal letters to Timothy and Titus. Apart from Paul, we have in the New Testament, two letters ascribed to Apostle Peter, the Epistle of James, three letters of Apostle John and Epistle of Jude. These letters, with reference to their universal nature and general form, is commonly called as Catholic, or general epistles. We also come across another letter, named as the Epistle to the Hebrews, whose authorship is disputed and is believed to have been written to a settlement of Jewish Christian in Jerusalem. In the early 60s a different genre in the form of Mark's Gospel came into prominence. It comprised of an historical narration of the life and teaching of Jesus. This became important to the new generation of believers of the early church. The first gospel to be written was the Gospel according to Mark. The Gospel according to Matthew and Luke were probably written 10 to 20 years after Mark, which includes more of Jesus' tradition parallels from Mark's gospel and a lost collection of sayings known as the Q source. Another form of Jesus' tradition found expression in the fourth Gospel known as the Gospel of John, which was written around 90 to 100 CE. A second part to the Gospel of Luke, which moved the story of Christianity beyond Jerusalem and Judea to Samaria and even to the ends of the earth, is found in the Acts of the Apostles. This book traces the journey of the apostles who spread the teachings of Jesus across the world. The last book of the New Testament belongs to the genre of apocalyptic literature. Filled with rich symbols, metaphors, heaven and earth parallelism, this vision of Apostle John comforts the seven churches in Asia Minor to have hope amidst the suffering they are facing. That's it for today.